So with some good news of him jumping back into the picture of 140, Sabriel Matias will be facing off against Roberto Ramirez. It's gonna be on November 9th. It's gonna be a lot of fights coming on in November 9th. I mean in November. With November 9th right around the corner, it's gonna be a lot of fights in November. It's gonna be in Puerto Rico. Should be a good matchup. I wanna see him back in the ring and see the different things he's doing. They have a pretty good undercard. I'm seeing some names that look familiar. A lot of guys that fought recently. A lot of these guys don't have that many losses. They have a pretty decent undercard. A lot of these guys been in some tough fights recently. But this is gonna be a good matchup for Matias, man. He needs to get back in here and fine-tune some things. I know he has some new training. I don't know who his new trainer is that he's working with or somebody he previously worked with. But it's gonna be a good showcase for him to go out there in front of the crowd, put on a good performance. It's easy for him to get back in the mix. For him to stay active right now is the most important thing. What would that be? 5 months after he fought, so that's good. He's staying active. I think he's a tough matchup for a lot of people right now. Would be kind of interesting. Still want to see Teofimo fight him. I mean, I don't think that's a bad thing, to be honest with you. I've seen plenty of fighters come off bad performances and still get shots at titles after a couple of situations and wins. So this would be a good situation. Then you have Jose Ramirez and Barbosa fighting soon. So 140 is going to get a lot more active soon. They're not going to sit a lot of these guys on the shelf. They didn't assign these guys to do that. So you're going to see a lot of different moves being made in a minute, but I'm glad these fights are getting put together. There's less talking going on, more fights getting made, and that's what you want to look for in the sport of boxing. Less talking and more moving and getting fighters in competitive fights against decent names, styles, trying to build a decent resume, just a fan base. And a lot of that's going on, but a lot of it's people trying to cut corners and use other guys' names. It just doesn't work that way. You gotta fight your way up to the top, to be honest with you. If you wanna have organic fans, a lot of people don't have organic fans now. They kinda just shoot their way up to the top using other people's names, and that's not the way it goes. But with Matias fighting in Puerto Rico, that'll be an excellent way to try to get the fans back to seeing him perform at a high level. I think he was right there. It was a close fight he was in. It wasn't a terrible loss like he got blown out or destroyed. It was a very, very close fight that he was in against Paulo. Paulo just pulled it out at the end, but it was a very close fight. It was nothing to be embarrassed by, to be honest with you. I mean, it was a loss in boxing. I'm pretty sure he'll have a chance to be champion in no time. Again, especially in the sport of boxing. We've seen how all these other guys have been losing at 140. So it's not a clear-cut elite guy at 140 right now. But what I will say, yeah, a lot of people, most people have lost at 140. 140 is a tough weight class to kind of stick around and just fight top competition and not fall victim to a loss. It's very tough right now. But with Matias, I think he'll be able to bounce back. He needs this kind of matchup. This is a tough guy who's going to try to come out there and make a name for himself. He's going to want to get paid well, want to get paid again. So that means if he wins and makes a name for himself, he can probably lead to a big payday for himself, Ramirez. So I think Matias is going to be ready.